Hey, it's Madison. Let's talk about RuPaul's Drag Race All-Star Season 2. So much happened in this season that was so, like, crazy, and everyone's been talking about it. I normally relate to the game. It happened several months ago, but I still, like, to this day, I can go on Facebook and see something about people mad because Alaska won, or they think Tatiana shouldn't have gone home that early, or they're mad that Adore quit. Like, listen, I have some things to say. I'm just gonna put my opinion out there because there's too much to, like, put in a Facebook comment or a Facebook post, like people have been doing in these groups that I'm in. Okay, first episode was a talent challenge for the main challenge. Okay, that talent show, like, parts of it were like, oh my god, cover my ears, that was bad, and then there's part, and then, like, for example, Adore Delano just, like, blew it out of the water and did really good, and then on the runway, when they did the judges' critiques, it was just like, okay, they're not really talking about the talent portion, which was, like, the majority of what that episode was about. Like, that was the main challenge. And they didn't even talk about it on the runway. They were talking about their runway looks. Like, really? Come on. That's not how it works. But that's all the judges were talking about. They were talking about the runway looks. They did not talk about the talent show very much. And I think that's the thing. When I heard about that they were going to be doing a talent show, I was like, yeah, Adore's got this, because I honestly thought that Adore was going to win that challenge, because I just know, like, she has such an amazing voice. I've listened to both her albums. I love her music. I've heard her on American Idol when, you know, little baby Danny was on American Idol back in 2008. And she has an amazing voice. She does. And then the fact that, you know, they didn't really like her runway outfit, specifically Michelle didn't like her runway outfit, and that was the only thing that she was judged on, and that got her put in the bottom three. I think that was honestly ridiculous. And, I'm glad that nobody, like, picked her to be voted off. Like, you know how they have the, they lip sync and they have the lipsticks. Well, everybody gets to pick their own person. Whoever wins the lip sync, that person's lipstick is who gets sent home. Both of them freaking picked Coco. And I think that's fair because she actually did really bad that entire episode. She just, like, and you would think for the amount of experience that she has in drag and the many years that she's been doing it, that she would be better than she is. But she just, like, I don't know. She just, it's kind of cringy because she just does so bad. She just does so bad. And, I don't know, I just didn't understand in the first episode how it was this whole big, okay, we're going to do this talent show, and then they didn't judge them on it. They really didn't. The majority of the critiques on the stage at the runway was about the runway look. It had nothing to do with the main challenge. I thought that was really stupid. The second person who got eliminated was Tatiana. And everyone's like, okay, well, I think that if Tatiana was still on the show, and if she wouldn't have got eliminated, then she probably would have won. I don't think so. I didn't like Tatiana in season 2. I mean, I don't know. I kind of liked her as a person. She was just, like, really shy and everything. But just, like, as far as her performances, she just kind of winged everything. Because she was just like, oh, I'm so shy. I don't know what to do. I'm so nervous. And then she would just, like, throw something together and just, like, wing it entirely. And she made it, correct me if I'm wrong, top 3 in season 2? No. 4. Yeah, top 4. And I'm just like, how did she make it that far? Because she just, it was accidental success all the way through. It really was. And the same way with All Stars. And everyone's like, oh, I think she would have won if she hadn't got eliminated. She got robbed. This whole thing is rigged. No, Tatiana's not that great. She's really not. Like, just straight up, she's not that great. And, she and Alyssa Edwards both won the lip sync and took Fifi's place. I've got something to say about Fifi later, but I'm not going to say that right now. But so they came back and they took Fifi's place. I don't think Tatiana should have won. I don't think that she should have been brought back into the competition, honestly, because, okay, she was brought back in, eliminated again. Like, what was the point? And she just, like, I've never thought she was, like, amazing, like, America's Next Drag Superstar. And that was said plenty of times in season 2. It was. And, okay, while I'm thinking about it, Fifi, okay, her main thing when she came back, she was like, I'm gonna be a nicer person, better than I was in season 4. And, okay, first of all, she was the only person from season 4 there. And, you know, first episode, yeah, she was better. And then episode 2, she was telling Roxy, you know, I'm kind of worried about your Spanish accent for, Sofia Vergara. And just, like, totally got in Roxy's head and just, like, made her second-guess herself so much that she ended up changing her character to Alaska and totally failed because she said, if you're not wearing wigs, you're not doing drag. That's not the quote that Alaska says. She says, if you're not wearing nails, you're not doing drag, not wigs. Her quote about wigs is, this is my hair, I don't wear wigs. And Ginger Minge was like, everyone knows that she has a song called This Is My Hair, I Don't Wear Wigs. Yeah, that was just like, oh my god. And that was all Fifi. Like, she got in her head so bad that she changed her character and lost. And she's just like, she's so unintentionally nasty and rude. But I loved Fifi in season 4, I'm not gonna say I didn't. I liked her. The whole twist with, you know, if you win the lip sync, you get to send someone home. I didn't really like that. I think it would have been better if it was, RuPaul's decision. And I agree with Coco on saying, you know, you think if it was RuPaul's decision, how would it have been different? And would it have been different? Yeah, I think a lot of the decisions would have been different. Not the win, obviously, who won the entire season, because, okay, and that's another thing, I'm tired of seeing that, like, people are saying, oh, Katya was robbed, it was rigged, the whole Facebook thing, she won the Facebook vote, but they chose Alaska anyway. Okay, that Facebook poll was simply for just, like, promoting the show. It had nothing to do with the actual final vote. Those votes on there meant nothing. The show was filmed, like, I think it was a year before it aired on TV. It had nothing to do with it. Because that poll was, like, right before they aired the episode, so it had nothing to do. It wasn't a live show. It had nothing to do with it. And honestly, I never liked Katya's style. I really didn't. It's just like, I don't know. It was always weird to me. And, you know, that doesn't have anything to do with whether she should have won or not. But, I mean, I didn't really like her as a person either. I just don't think that it's fair to say that Alaska should not have won just because you like Katya. Like, just because you're a bigger fan of Katya doesn't mean Alaska didn't deserve to win. Like, that's the attitude that people are taking towards this, and it's so stupid. Okay. Another thing, a door quitting. A lot of people have said, you know, if she didn't quit, you know, she may have won. And I've thought that a couple times myself because I love Adore Delano. I talk about her every day. You can ask my friends, they'll tell you that I talk about Adore Delano way too much. And just like, okay, I understand why she did it. Like, not just the reason that she said on the show, but the thing that she said afterwards. That, like, she explained it more, but she didn't want to say that stuff on TV. Everyone's, like, so mad that she quit. Like, why would you do that? Why? You've been given this incredible opportunity and just give it up. Basically, the same thing that Alaska said on the show when she quit. She was like, I'm so upset with what's going on with the door because we've all been given this amazing opportunity. And it just upsets me that something like that, she would just, you know, give that all up. And, you know, I understand that too, but at the same time, her dad had just passed away. Her boyfriend had just broken up with her. Just all this stuff that was going on. And then at the same time, like, the thing that she said on there, like, she had been touring and working with Michelle Visage. They were, like, really good friends. And then just come back on the show, and she's just so negative and rude towards her. I understand that she was judging her, but it just seems like I said earlier, with the whole talent show thing, they didn't judge her on that, and that she was really good in the talent competition, and I knew she would be. And they were just like, your runway was trash, bottom three. And, oh my gosh, it just made me so mad. But I really do think that if Adore had stayed in, she would have been at least top five. Okay, Alaska. She did amazing every single freaking challenge. I love Alaska. I thought she should have won her season. Monsoon, I was so mad when she won season 5 because, like, no one paid attention to her the whole season. She was just kind of there. And then all of a sudden, she's in the top 4 and sends Detox home. And it's like, where the heck did Jinx come from? No one expected her to win. And then she's just top 3. Everyone was like, oh, Alaska's gonna win. And then she didn't, and it was Jinx Monsoon, and everyone was like, what? And then she comes on All-Stars, and everyone's like, oh, Katya should have beat Alaska. Alaska didn't deserve to win. She's not even good. Like, just because you like Katya more than Alaska does not mean that Alaska did not deserve to win. I'll say that again. So much happened. I love Alyssa Edwards. I'm so glad that she made it as far as she did because, oh, she's so great. I didn't like her at first in season 5, but I grew to love her after the show. When I was watching, like, her YouTube videos and stuff, I love Alyssa. I love Alyssa Edwards. The whole thing, the whole back rolls thing, I love that. It's hilarious. Party. I love Adore Delano. I can't. I need to stop. Oh, I thought it was so funny. Like, there was so many season 5 queens. And then, in true season 5 fashion, it was Alaska Talks. And one other person in the top 4 again. And this time, in season 5, it was Alaska, Jinx Monsoon, Roxy Andrews, and Detox. Detox got sent home. And I was shocked, honestly. I thought it was going to be Alaska Talks in the top 3. And then Detox went home. I didn't think that was a good choice, honestly. Okay, I'll say this. Detox was my favorite from the first episode in season 5. And then I actually started, like, paying more attention to Alaska. And I love Alaska. She's amazing. I have her album, Anus. That's just so, I mean, it sounds so weird, but it's so Alaska. And, okay, and then All-Star Season 2, it was Alaska Talks and one of the person in the final 4 again. It was Katya, Alaska, Detox, and Roxy. And this time, instead of Detox going home and being in fourth place, it was Roxy, which I was a little bit surprised by, honestly. It was going to go exactly the way of season 5. Like, when I found out that Alaska won, I was just like, yeah, I mean, I saw that coming. I knew it was going to be Alaska from the very first episode, because not only was she really good in season 5, but she got more experience from the time between season 5 and All-Stars 2, and she got so much better. And she really did deserve that win. I knew from episode 1 that she was going to be at least in the top 3, if not win. And she won, and I'm so, like, it frustrates me so much when people are like, she didn't deserve to win, because she did. She really did. And, you know, I do wish that Adore had stayed in longer, because I do think that she would have gone pretty far in the competition, because she's an overall great drag queen, and a great person, too. I don't know, it's frustrating at this, but at the same time you understand, because the things that she was going through at the time, and she was really depressed and didn't really want to be there, and she did regret it later on that she left the show, and she was the first person to ever just leave, but it would have been nice to see where she'd have went. Especially when she did so good in season 6 Snatch Game, and she didn't stay for the entire episode, so she didn't get to actually perform in that challenge this time. And her and Nicole Smith was so good in season 6. I was kind of surprised that she didn't win that challenge in season 6. Yeah, so it would have been really cool to see what she would have done with her character. Because it was just, hers was so good in season 6, you know? Alright, that is all I've got. I'm not going to sit here and talk about Adore Delano for, like, forever and a day. just hit me up if you want me to talk about Adore, because I'll talk to you about Adore all day long. And Alaska. I'll talk to anybody about Adore in Alaska. Okay, I'm gonna go. Bye.